If I could get everybody's attention. I'd like to welcome you all here, and some of you have been before, so you've heard my little wing it speech, but I kind of wrote some stuff down. We're doing things a little bit differently today because the group is so large. So I apologize, but I'm going to read it because I'm not a great public speaker. So I just wanted to say that if you've been nominated before or come with a nominee, you may notice that this is an exceptionally large group. I point this out for a few reasons. First of all, I think it shows that the Alamance County government employees are a strong, caring, and emotionally supportive group of people. Even if they themselves are not having a stellar day, we continue to strive for the best, and we set the bar higher for government employees everywhere. And I truly believe that to be true. I know that these people would probably agree. Secondly, I wanted to point this out because we're going to do things a little bit differently today. Normally we read every nomination and have the individual come up for a photo. Michelle Mills in the county management office will send that out with the write-ups, and that's out there for anybody who wants to go in and read them and look at it and whatnot. Today, since we had 42 nominations, we actually have 43, but one has since retired. So we're not going to read that one, but 42 nominations, so we figured it might take a while, and I hope that none of you feel like, you know, we're not reading yours because it wasn't, you know, up to par with everybody else. I think they're all fantastic. So what I did was I just kind of went through and randomly flagged every fourth one. They're going to read those. All the rest of them will be on the publication that Michelle sends out later. So when yours is read, or if you're just called up, if you'll just pose with the people up here for your picture, and that way when it gets published, people will know who the face that goes along with the deed. So I encourage all of you to please, when that gets sent out, to go on and read what she sends. There's some really great, fantastic examples of the good work that you and your peers do every day for the county. So with that being said, I'm gonna go ahead and let Amy and Bob, if you wanna say anything, go ahead, or if you just wanna get started.
I'll just say how honored I am to be here today. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Amy Gailey. I'm the chair of the Board of Commissioners, and it's a real privilege to represent the people of Alamance County and also to work with you all as you go about performing the functions of county government. It's just a delight to get to know each of you and to celebrate with you the things that you've accomplished through your careers and through your work for the county. And on behalf of the citizens of the county, it's my honor to be here today to say thank you for what you do. So I'm gonna start by reading this one and then presenting the next three. This is for Tina Reese, Alamance County Social Services. And is she here, Tina? Oh, great, come on up here. A supervisor received the following email that had been sent to the county manager by a customer Tina helped, and it's just one example of what this supervisor witnesses from Tina on a daily basis. I had a situation that I needed some assistance with, and that is how I met Tina. Once I spoke with Tina, she explained to me my options in a way that was very clear. She got me the information that I needed and went out of her way to ensure we were taken care of, to the extent of, on her way home, dropping off paperwork on my behalf. She is a true blessing with a servant's heart. I can see how someone could become callous with the clients of social services. However, what I experienced with Tina today was the exact opposite. She was warm, encouraging, and listened intently to my story and needs. Most importantly, she did what she said she was going to do in the time frame she said she was going to do it in. I'm not sure if the employee program is still in effect, but Tina should receive a pat on the back, a gold star, or a shout from the mountaintop.
Thank you very much.
We can't go down to the mountain, so we will give her a pat on the back and this gold star. So, come on, let's get it. Robert Andrews of the Alamance County Print Shop.
Yes.
you would hold the certificate. Good job. Two on one, Tammy Crawford and Cindy Royston of the Alamance County Veterans Services. There you go, Tammy. There you go, all right.
Two plates. Thank you.
Good job, thank you. And Linda Dunn with the Register of Deeds.
I don't think she would think she's here.
Oh, great.
All right, Mike. Well, I would like to just add a couple of comments and just to say how important it is to be recognized by your peers. So it's one thing, or by the people that you serve out in the community. It's one thing to be recognized by your boss or the county management, but to be recognized by your peers or the people that you serve, I think, is a little bit more special. And I know that's the way I felt when I was working at the hospital for many years. Thank you for what you do. So the next person is Jada Cook. I say that right? Ms. Cook went above and beyond to help me. She was patient and very kind all throughout. She went out of her way to be helpful and exemplified customer service. Very hard to find public servants that are so genuine and seem to love their job. She was so helpful and knowledgeable. She was the epitome of what everyone should work for as a county employee.
Wow.
Thank you. And next we have Thomas Southern from the Parks Department.
Thank you. All right. You know, especially when they compliment the tax department. Especially in Alamance County.
And the person I just met, Roger Allison from Inspection. Randy Light from EMS. She's not ready here. All right.
Okay. Rafael Agueda. Did I say that right?
You did.
Oh, he's not here. Okay, well, he's got a green flag, so I'm going to read it. Yeah, a lady with small, he's from the Sheriff's Department. A lady with small children just left out of child support, and she came into the county manager's office said she needed a note for work. She didn't want to walk it all the way back over to the courtroom. Raphael overheard the conversation that I was having with the lady and the child support agent. He asked the lady for her identification and full name. He took it upon himself to go over to the courtroom and ask the clerk for a note for the lady to take to work. He did not have to do that. He could have just reinforced what the child support agent said. He went beyond the call of duty to assist this lady with her small children. That's pretty. Okay, Jackie Davis.
One, two, thank you.
And Levert White from the landfill. Did I pronounce that right, Mr. White?
Close enough.
Thank you.
So next is Sharon Stewart from Social Services.
Can I just say something about Sharon real quick? She actually was nominated on 3 different occasions during this quarter. I did write them all up separately, but if you just want to read the top one or whatever you just want.
Well, this first sentence is good. Sharon is literally out of this world. She arrives to work every day with a smile on her face, no matter how gloomy it is outside or stressful it is inside. Sharon is an extremely hard worker and never complains when the workload seems to increase due to various factors. She's an employee that really knows what being a part of the clerical team is all about, keeping the rest of the agency running like a well-oiled machine. Being no stranger to putting in extra time after work, her amazing attitude and bubbly personality really motivates the entire team to keep pushing. Sharon Stewart is extremely well deserving of both this nomination and free Pepsi for a lifetime. And then we have Sharon Tyler from the Veterans Office. Oh, I'm sorry, Shannon Tyler from the Veterans Office.
She's not here.
Okay. And then, I'll get this one right this time. Teresa Harvey from the Planning Department.
Lisa Fawcett of the Department of Social Services.
Haney from the library.
She's not here.
Not here. Well, I'll read it. I work full-time. I usually pick up my two-year-old daughter up at 5:30 p.m. from daycare. We arrived at the Grand Library a little after 6 p.m. on Wednesday. I realized as we approached the doors that they had just closed. My daughter was so upset and started to cry. I had promised her that morning that we would visit the library. She had been asking to go to the library for the past week. Ms. Haney came out and apologized for the closing. She told us that the Burlington Library branch was open until 9 p.m. My daughter was so happy and I was very grateful to be able to keep my promise. Big thank you to Ms. Katie Haney. Cynthia Pierce from Cooperative Extension. Services was not the leading agency on this case, but our community partner requested APS assistance. Randy never complained and was diligent in responding and assisting the agency. This case also required Randy to work with Child Protective Services. As Randy's supervisor, I have received two compliments regarding this case from different partners about Randy's professionalism, respect, and ability to provide education regarding the Adult Protective Services process. Randy is always cheerful and positive in educating our community about Adult Protective Services and the current need of our disabled and elderly citizens. It is a pleasure to be Randy's supervisor. Okay, next is Mark Cockery.
And had recently moved from her home to an apartment, so that her house could be remodeled. During the move, she was unable to move her concentrator due to the weight of it, and she had no family to help her. She had used up all of her portable O2 tanks and was completely out of oxygen this morning when she went to walk her dog. Unfortunately, during the walk, she became hypoxic and had to sit down and call 911 for help. Troy and John cared for her and brought her to us, where we discovered that her concentrator was still in her old house. Immediately, Troy suggested that they could go back to her old house and retrieve her concentrator and bring it to her new apartment for her. After receiving approval from his supervisor, Troy and John went back to her house and completed the task for her. She was incredibly grateful, to say the least. This was such an amazing testament to the amazing people we work alongside every day in this ER. They went over and beyond what had to be done and showed true compassion and care. In theory, once they got here, they could have dropped her off and went back into service, but they saw the need and made sure it was met. I am so proud to work beside these fine men and grateful they serve the community where I live.
Special thing, and every time this is my favorite day of the quarter. I come out as a department head, and then now as assistant county manager. You guys really inspire me to do a good job every day. And those didn't get those read, go, it'll be online. You should go back and read it because it really energizes you to do even better every day. And I just want to say thank you.